morning time to you down there, Miss Lois Lane. Hope you're having a good day down that way. Lois Lane, Audio Man with a wave. Get right back, Miss Lois Lane, 525. Good to hear you up this way. Tell that doggone Superman we did say hello when you see him down that way. Lois Lane, Audio Man with the wave. It's a little rough and tough out there around the edges there, Lois Lane, but you cutting the butter. Hey, Lois Lane, you cutting that duck fucking butter all the way up here in Canton, Ohio, without a doubt. Lois Lane, always good to hear you on the air. Audio Man's back out. Turkey Day down that way. Hey, Lois Lane, Audio Man says, I hope you have a good Turkey Day down that way. Audio Man, hi-fi. Crazy sound got down.
Happy Thanksgiving to y'all on Tuesday.
And right on there, there's another lady come in there, but I didn't catch who that was. Lord have mercy. I don't know who that other female voice was that came in there, but Audio Man gonna say hello and a Turkey Day your wave. Turkey Day your way also, ain't no doubt. All right, Lois Lane, keep on with keeping on down there, girl. And tell Superman I said hello. Audio Man's back up. Thanksgiving down there, big brother. Good to hear you, my receiver. Busy B, Audio Man, waving right back.
Busy B was a young lady waving. They call me Fireball, Northwest Mississippi. 417, waving at your Audio Man. Glad to finally make contact with you, no sign.
10 Raj on that there, 457, I believe he said. But, Busy B, I take it that that must have been your better half or your daughter or somebody was grabbing your microphone. Shoo-wee, man, get her back on there. Tell her, come on up and talk to Audio a little bit here, break.
That was Softball Man's daughter. Softball Man, the one that makes all that noise down here in the Magnolia. That's his daughter. Fireball, I'm just a neighbor. Waving a hand, maybe she'll get back in there and holler at her. I told her to, but she might be shy now.
On that there, little softball. Come on in here. Oh, Audio Man won't bite you. I promise you that. I will not bite you, girl. Come on in to Canton, Ohio a little bit. Little softball girl, Audio Man with a big wave your way.
Sick. I cried for 2 days, but I'm going back after him Saturday. Anyway, I just went
antique radio stuff still sounding out there. I got me some new gamma matches from flat side and vertical side for these six of them. I got them sitting here put together. I'm going at deer season, right after Thanksgiving, I'm gonna put them on there. And I got some 5,000-watt gamma matches. I think I done wore them muds out and blow them out, but I'm having to talk on the vertical side right now because the SWR done went crazy on the flat side. But anyway, the audio man, you been doing all right out there the way?
Oh, yeah, big brother. I've been doing real good. Mother Nature must be twisting that doggone signal around from that vertical to this horizontal doggone set of diamonds, man. But they have been modified since the last time we talked. But, yeah, man, you're doing good. Doing good. Ain't no doubt. We're doing good, man. You know, a little bit sick around here, not feeling all the best and whatnot. But other than that, man, the children are doing great. That's the main thing. The children are doing great. But, you know, life is what it is, no doubt about it. Crazy cowboy, you don't worry about nothing, man. You got sole control of my radio right now. And I don't say that to get everybody ramping up in here, but you're definitely doing a mighty fine, good job in my receiver there, Roger.
Conditions been kind of hazy and crazy lately, man. You know, get it when you get it when you don't, and all this other doggone mess. But don't worry about that doggone glass. Hey, I call that class working with glass, man. I could say it another way, but I don't want to upset nobody. But you know, when you work with class, sometimes you smack that. I ain't gonna say it. I'm not gonna say it. But but working with class is like glass or class. Yeah. Yeah, working with glass is like class. Ain't no doubt in my mind. Ain't nothing wrong with that, man. Some of us like to work doggone steel. Some of us like to work glass. And some of us like to work them transistors, man. It's all, you know, a self-preference, ain't no doubt. But, yeah, we're doing all right, man. Everything is good and gravy. Ain't no doubt in my mind. Hey, crazy cowboy, I don't know if you could tell, man, but I did change up my sound a little bit, man. I went ahead and direct-injected my Cobra 2000 the other night, man. Audio man done. I couldn't believe I did it, man. But when I found out how easy it was to direct-inject these doggone radios, Lord have mercy, I said, somebody give me my soldering iron there, can ya?
Yeah, well, whatever you done to that, tell the difference. It sounds good. I got a couple of amps here. I traded for one.
Could be something like that. I'm not real sure, man. I'm not a technician. Hey, hey, crazy cowboy, don't take me wrong, man. I am not a technician. But I'll tell you this, brother, to direct inject this doggone Cobra 2000, the truth of the matter, it takes more time to get the covers off of it than it takes to do the little bit of solder work that it takes, man. Yeah, within 10 duck plucking minutes, it was done. That's covers off and covers back on. Hey, crazy cowboy, it was just that easy there. Go ahead.
Yeah, You must have went in there at that modulation dial. I know all these old, like this old General Stonewall Jackson, I talk on them old Galaxy bass radios. You can go in there at that modulation dial and twist two of them together and put two of them together, and that thing will romp and stomp then. That's about what you'd probably done, was it?
Yeah, in a phrase of a way, yeah. You pop one out, you replace it with a better one, and you run this line over to that duck plucking half-inch jack, you run that other line over there, that half-inch jack, and just let it do its thing, if you know what I mean.
Yeah,
break. Between my Cobra 2000 and that Mark II Browning sitting up there, man, it would be a real hard decision to have to let one of these two items go among all my other radios, without a doubt. But, hey, sometimes you got to do what you got to do, man. It's all good. No pain, no strain, man. You can always get another one back. But around these parts, it's kind of hard to come across a good Cobra 2 Grand and a Mark II that ain't been all whacked and jacked. Ain't no doubt about that there. Go ahead.
Yeah. I got a friend over there. He's got a Cobra 2000. I mean, he bought it brand new and got both speakers with it. I mean, he ain't got a blemish on it nowhere. He got a bunch of more stuff. He wants to sell it to me at $600 or quite a bit of stuff. Not sure what thing about buying it. Just to get that one radio, that Cobra 2 Grand. I'm going to look like they built it last week and put it in a box and sent it to you. I mean, the cover ain't never been off. It's still got the sticker, you know, when they put the little sticker on the bottom of it there, you know, if you break that seal, they won't warrant. It's still got that on there, and he still got the box that he come in. I said, the box is probably worth more than the radio.
You're right, too, man. That box is worth a big, pretty penny, no doubt in my mind. God, dog, man. It's good to hear you rolling up in here sounding real good, man. Sounding really good in my receiver. Good gracious alive, man.
Oh, well, audio, man. I'm going to send you two cup loads of them flowers back out there of the way, because I guess me and you the only ones in here. I don't hear nobody else. I sure don't hear nobody when you key it up, because my needle, looking at my needle on my radio, it goes from over there in that right-hand corner and it locks up in this stage right there. You just, like you're sitting here in this room, gang, and talking with me, talking that big crazy cowboy right back to you, audio man.
10 Roger on that there, crazy cowboy. Well, you got soul control right now, that's for sure. But I'll give them flowers to the better half. And, brother, I'm going to send you a big box full of them golden tickets, man, because, you know, I don't ever give a man flowers. I don't like that idea. But, crazy cowboy, I got no problem passing out these duck fucking golden tickets, and you get a big shoebox full there. Go ahead. Well, we can do it like that right there. I hope I don't push a needle too far in that duck fucking corner. But we have had a good talk show, man. Ain't no doubt in my mind. Hey, crazy cowboy, throw them numbers at me one more time. And as I unkey, I'm going to go ahead and hit the brakes on this here video gate. Ain't no doubt. Crazy cowboy, always a pleasure to have you in Canton, Ohio. Your audio man working this hi-fi sound. Full direct inject Cobra 2 Grand, audio man.